Christmas. It is Christmas in July. This week at camp would have been holiday camp. On Saturday, we're celebrating our country's birthday. Don't tell anyone, though. It's a surprise. No, I'm kidding. Wouldn't that be fun if our country had, like, a surprise birthday party instead of, like, normal fireworks? Like, we don't do fireworks, and then, like, on July 4th, and, like, kind of nothing happens, and the country's like, guys, what happened to me? Remember me? Like, red, white, and blue? But then, like, on the next day, July 5th, like, Canada and Mexico were like, surprise! And we even invited Central America. Are your cousins? That would be a lot of fun, wouldn't it? No, let's just keep doing it the way we're doing it. But Merry Christmas, and happy birthday, and happy Thanksgiving, and happy all the other holidays that you celebrate. Today on The Camp Show, we are going to be celebrating mostly Christmas, because let's be honest, it's kind of like the best holidays of all the holidays. As you can tell, I've been decorating my office. I even got one of these guys, one of the nutcrackers. The only thing is that, have you ever tried cracking nuts with these? It kind of doesn't work, but they're fun to play with. That's actually incredibly strong. Anyway, but we have so much fun that we're going to be doing today. A lot of things planned. But first of all, we want to get to our dress up contest. Now, our dress up contest, we had some incredible dress up contest pictures sent in. Here are our favorite dress up contestants. Check it out. Congratulations to all of our contestants. You were fantastic, but we have to pick a winner, and I gotta be honest, this week was really, really hard. But we have a tie, a three-way tie, for our three reindeer siblings, so all of the kids from the Woods family, congratulations, you are our dress-up contest winners. Look at all of those kids. They're adorable. Little bitty reindeers. I wonder what they're doing during the summer. What do reindeers do during the summer? Sleep? Work out, maybe? Oh, reindeer games. They play reindeer games. Let Rudolph play, okay? Anyway, moving right along to our next thing, we have our impossible shot. Now, we have seen mostly basketball impossible shots, but we are now going to something completely different, which is very incredible, very creative. It's from our friend Libby. Here is this week's impossible shot. Check it out.
Whenever you're ready.
Seven, eight, nine, and 10 and a half. Making a little bit of hot chocolate. It is holiday camp. Secret recipe, 10 scoops of Swiss mix, and then, I don't have a spoon. I don't need it. I went on Amazon and found out, you know, like when you get the Swiss mix, it has the little tiny baby marshmallows in it, you know, like the little newborn marshmallows. You can go and you can get an entire jar of these. So you can scoop. I usually do 10 scoops, but since it's a special day, and honestly, like the whole COVID thing is just getting to me. Don't eat that. All right, there we go. That is just about perfect. Yep. Bottoms up. Yes. Now that is hot chocolate. Wow. This is really good. I probably shouldn't eat as much of it because it's got a lot of sugar in it, but it's okay, I don't care. If you eat
a lot of the marshmallows, it kind of tastes like Lucky Charms. You know the cereal with the hearts and things? Ooh! Alright,
I'm gonna keep eating this. I'm gonna keep drinking all the sugar. I'm having a lot of fun. Here's a video retro moment. Hope you enjoy it. I'll talk to you later. I gotta finish this. The sugar's really starting to hit my blood. Here we go.
Christmas tree. Let me tell you my story.
What is there a Christmas tree doing over here in the middle of the summer?
Christmas, let's be glad. Even if your life's been bad, there are presents to be had. Take a walk out in the snow and hear Santa's ho ho ho. He's got a million miles to go. La 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 la. Let's be glad, even if the year's been bad, there are presents to be had, a promotion for your dad, don't be angry, don't be
walking Christmas tree. We could use him for holiday camp. Hey, I work at Camp Straight Street. It's holiday camp. Would you come be in our rally?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'll set you up an interview today. Will you come with me now?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
I know Mom's got a tattoo, but that doesn't mean you'll have to have matching ones. No, I don't care if Brad and Angelina did it. It doesn't matter. I gotta go. I have a Christmas tree here for a job interview. I don't know. Blue spruce, I think. I'm not sure. I have to go. All right. Adios. So, you're a Christmas tree. Seen him before. Not the first one. I got one in my house every year. I don't know what makes you so special. Now, you do talk. I've never seen one of those before, although my aunt's got one. You push the little button and it dances. Christmas trees are a dime a dozen. We got a ton of them. We don't need another Christmas tree. What we do need is someone or something, whatever you are, to spread Christmas cheer. Because Christmas cheer can't be bought in the store. You can't find Christmas cheer on eBay, my friend. You know where Christmas cheer comes from? A little place called Heart. Ever heard of it? And what I need from you is for you to spread Christmas cheer. Now, do you think you can do that? That? Well, that's the Christmas question. Well, now that you know what I need, I'm wondering, have you got the Christmas cheer chops? Let me see what you got. Christmas tree. You got the job! Yeah! Good job!
Not a good idea. I drank all of it. I don't feel so good. I think I'll be okay. Listen, sometimes Christmas, you can have too much of a good thing. I think I just ate too much of a good thing. You know what? Here's some videos of people enjoying Christmas a little too much. Check it out.
We wish you the merriest, the merriest, the merriest, yes, the merriest. We wish you the merriest, the merriest, the merriest. Your cheer. We wish you the happiest, happiest,
the happiest.
Yes, the happiest.
We wish you the happiest, the happiest, the happiest. The happiest. May your tree be filled with happiness.
Happiness and happiness for all.
May your heart be filled with cheerfulness.
Happiness and cheerfulness for all.
We wish you the happiest, the happiest, the happiest.
Yes, the happiest.
We wish you the merriest, the merriest, the merriest. You cheer and the happiest.
Check that out. Snow cone machine from camp. You can make snowballs. Isn't that awesome? I thought about making a bunch of these and then going over and throwing them at cars as they drive past camp. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do that. But I am going to try and save them up and then make them and put them in the freezer. And then when all of the virus stuff is out, we can go run around and throw them at each other. So I'm going to keep making as many of these as... Ooh, it's cold, as I possibly can. You know, we don't normally do this. We usually do one retro video moment. But since it's Christmas, and one of the best things about Christmas is watching Christmas specials, we thought we would have a double retro video moment. And it would not be holiday camp at Camp Straight Street without everyone's favorite canned meat. You know what I'm talking about. That's right. Captain Vienna Sausage. No, I'm just kidding. Of course, I'm talking about Spam. Everyone's favorite Christmas character. If you've never been to camp, you have no idea what I'm talking about. And if you have, you know what I'm talking about. Here it is with a lovely Christmas video is Spam. I'm going to keep making some more snowballs. I'll catch up with you in a minute.
I hate Christmas. And we all know that I hate pumpkins too. But I almost hate Christmas more than pumpkins. Those stupid little pumpkins and cans, and they'll eat the pumpkins and... I hate pumpkins. But anyway, back to Christmas. Every Christmas season, I've been given as a gift. And it's been horrible. It all started on my first Christmas ever, when I was a wee little lad.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear voices singing, let's be jolly, deck the halls with
pie. I was just a little can of Spam, and they gave me for a Christmas present. They had never tried Spam before, but once they saw it, they knew they hated it. They judged me before they even tasted me. One of the next worst Christmases was when I was placed in a little stocking for a snot-nosed little brat named Larry. He didn't like anything that he got, much less Spam. I felt degraded. And the lowest memory that I have of my Spam can life was at an office party.
She moves the stapler around. Like, I'll have
it here.
It's because
she hates you.
Yeah, you know what?
It's because you're wearing black.
Well,
she also jams it.
Well, she needs to leave my stapler where it is and not have me going on a goose hunt for a stapler.
But I like gooses.
We're talking about a stapler.
But you said a goose hunt.
For a stapler. That Sally, the annoying lady that's in my cubicle, right next to me, takes my stapler.
Aren't you coming to the Christmas party?
No, why would I do that?
Because everyone's going to be there and there's free food.
What, free food?
Yes.
Okay.
They were playing Dirty Santa, and I was one of the gifts.
All right, number 50.
That's me.
Go, go, Mikey!
iPad, really? Y'all know I hate Apple. Why did you do this? This is like the worst thing in the world.
Sorry.
Like.
All right, 51.
I thought that I was the best gift there, but apparently when I was drawn, they all laughed at the person who got the gift.
Who eats Spam? Why would y'all?
But I knew they weren't laughing at him. They were laughing at me. I was the terrible gift. But this Christmas, I think it'll be different.
Oh, thank you, son. These will be perfect for getting into shape. You're such a dear son. Thank you so much. Well, I have a gift for you, but as you know, it's been a really hard year. What with the drought and the famine, the cows dying, it's been hard. But I got you this present.
Spam?
Thank you for
Thanks, Mom.
Oh, you're welcome, son. I'm just glad it's something you love.
I'm gonna go outside and play with it.
Your heart is true, you're a pal and a confidant. I'm not ashamed to say, I hope it always will stay this way. My hat is off, won't you stand up and take a bow? And if you threw a party, invited everyone you knew, well, you would see the biggest gift would be for me, and the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being
That sure was fun.
I know, right? Good times.
You know, I really think you're my best friend.
Well, you're my best friend, too.
Well, in that case, I have a huge favor I need to ask you.
Sure, anything.
Well, you see, I've been passed down from generation to generation, and no one's really been my friend. And, well, first, I've got to teach you a song.
Okay.
It goes like this. Spam, spam, the friendly meat, a special treat that's fun to eat. Spam, spam, the friendly meat. What are we going to eat today?
Is there something wrong?
Look, you have to do this for me, okay?
Okay.
As my best friend, you're gonna have to eat me.
No, I couldn't do that. You're my best friend.
You have to. If you're really my best friend, you'll do this.
No, I won't do it.
You have to. It's what I was made for, okay? It's my destiny. I think it's your destiny to eat me.
Okay. I'll eat you.
You'll do it?
I'll do it. I have to do it. She's my friend. Spam, spam, friendly meat. Oh, he wants me to do this. Oh, you're so good. You delicious meat.
Bam, bam, trust me.
I gotta get this over with.
Oh.
I got a good start on my my snowballs, looking pretty good. I had to turn the air conditioning down as low as it'll go, about 50. It won't go down below 32 for some reason. I don't want the snowballs melting. Anyway, so it's getting a little cold in here. It's a good thing I got on my Camp Straight Street sweatshirt. But I thought it would be really fun, since it's camp and it's holiday camp, that we would sing some Christmas carols, one of the things we love to do at a holiday camp. So instead of singing our normal Superman song and For You, I thought we would sing some Christmas songs. Oh my goodness. I think I cut the air conditioning on a little too low. It's starting to snow in here. Oh. Well, it's perfect. I guess we should do some singing. Maybe you'll sing with me. Here we go. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Oh, then how the reindeers loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, he'll go down in history. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Jingle bells, jingle bells, oh jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing our sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, oh, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. All right, we're going to do one more song. This one's one of my favorites. You ready? It goes like this. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero Año y Felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero Año y Felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. This song kinda goes on forever. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero Año y Felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. This song's long. Wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Good heavens, this is going on forever. wish you a Merry Christmas. I don't want to sing this song. All right, I'm just stopping it. I can't do this. My fingers are starting to bleed. Sorry. That song has no exit strategy. Well, it is time to play a very special Christmas version of the game. This Christmas game is going to be using an iPhone, kind of like this. Here's what's going to happen. We are going to use a cell phone, and it is going to you're going to see like kind of a screen video of someone typing or doing different things, going to different apps, searching things on the internet, and you have to see if you can guess what Christmas carol they're trying to get you to guess. So there's going to be some clues. See if you can watch them. Here's the first one. It'll give you a good idea of how this game is played. So see if you can figure out what Christmas carol they're trying to get you to guess using their cell phone. Here's the first one. Check it out. All right, you kind of see what they were doing? Did you figure it out? Let us see what the answer is. It was Silent Night. That's right, Silent Night. Here is our next Christmas carol. See if you can get it. You got this one? This one's kind of easy. I think you can do it. Let's see what the answer is. That's right. It is Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Let's try our next iPhone quiz. Here we go. Now that is a lot of reminders for a lot of different days. 12 days? Let's see what the answer is. It was the 12 Days of Christmas. The worst Christmas song ever. No one wants 11 Lords of Leaping. 10 max, but 11, too much. Here is our next question. All right, did you figure it out? This one's one of my favorites. Here's the answer. All right, this one is going to be a little tricky, but I think you can get it because you're smart and I like you. And I'm going to tell you the answer, and I have no idea if you got it right or wrong. Doesn't matter. Here it is. Figure it out? Someone playing cards and then going to a pharmacy? Card pharmacy? No, you know what it is. Check it out. That's right. Deck the halls. Deck of cards. You got it? Yep. All right. Here is our next Christmas carol. Are you on to it? Let's see how you did. Here is the answer. That's right. It's the first Noel. All right, this next one, we are going to check out some ice cream. Are you ready? Here it is. Did you figure it out? Looks like we're going to Wendy's to get ourselves some chocolate ice cream, although that's not what Wendy's calls it. They call it something else. Here's the answer. Frosty the Snowman! Of course! All right, here is our next one. For this one, we are gonna go into outer space. It's not like an alien Christmas song because those aren't real. Here it is, though. Oh, did you figure it out? Here's the answer if you didn't. All right, we're saving the hardest ones for last. We got two more to go. Here is one of the tricky ones. Check it out. Are you ready to see the answer? Here is the answer. All right, it's time for the last one, and this one is the hardest one. This one's kind of tricky. Here it is. Do you know the answer? See if you can get it right. Here we go. Silver bells. That's a tricky one. Well, hey, I hope you enjoyed playing our game. And now we have important things to get to. It is time for a very special Christmas version of The Sing-Off. This week's sing-off, we have two people. We have Katie Rainwater and James Bowen. Both are going to be singing a Christmas song. Are you ready? We're gonna go first of all to Katie, who's singing a Christmas classic, Get Ready to Rock, with Katie, Around the Christmas Tree. Here we go.
Let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll old-fashioned way.
Well done, Katie. What a rocket. And now we have a very special treat. James is going to be singing a Christmas song. He's going to be singing White Christmas, but he's not going to be doing it alone. He's going to be singing with two other of his very best friends. Honestly, his only friends. Here is James Bowen and his two best buddies singing White Christmas.
Dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where those treetops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow, but in I am dreaming of a white Christmas. With every Christmas card I write, may your days, be merry and bright. And may all your Christmases be white.
Making a lot. I am going to be very ready if anyone tries to attack my office right now. Got a lot of snowballs happening. We want to check in with Half a Horse. To be honest with you, I talked to Half a Horse, and being a holiday, him and I decided to take the week off from our shenanigans. However, we did get some security footage of some things going on. I really don't know what's going on, to be honest with you. Maybe you can help me figure out what's going on. Check this out.
Oh, this one is... Hippity-hoppity, this camp is not my problem!
Wait, where is he?
Well, he didn't leave a note. Maybe he's in here. He's not in here! Are you in here? Half Horse? Are you in here? Are you in here? Half Horse? Where are you? Half Horse? I demand a figure! Half Horse.
Half horse, are you in there? He's not in there. Okay.
Can't believe I haven't found him anywhere yet. Talk to Jawu.
Jawu, where is he now? This is outrageous. I cannot believe that. Oh, what's this? What's this?
Jawu and Half Horse are both out due to Christmas and July break and celebrating their birthdays.
What kind of camp are they running in this place? I swear! They're both gone. I'm the only one here. I am the king of the war! Yeah, that was amazing! Yeah! Oh, this is the best day ever! Together, my comrades, we will rule this camp with an iron fist and a green thumb! Who's with me? Yeah! That's what I like to hear!
Day. Oh, I should call Half Horse and gloat about it.
Hey guys, well, I have been a busy little boy making a lot of snowballs. Man, we are going to have one incredible snowball fight. I'm going to put these in the freezer so we can have them ready to go for next year. No worries. Hey, next week is build camp, and I want you to know that we have a little Lego contest. Normally, we have a Lego contest at camp, but you at your house probably have Lego, so here's what I want you to do. I want you to build something out of Legos and send me a picture that we can then show on our show next week for build camp. But here's what I want you to do. I want you to build something that has to do with camp. So you can build like the water slides, you could build like the rally room, you could make a Lego set with your like your team or your team room or whatever you want, just as long as it has to do with camp. Send in your pictures to me. The email is right here at the bottom, and we will feature it. Also, the best Lego set that we see, the best build, we're going to send them their very own Lego set as a little thank you for being so awesome. Also, don't forget, if you want to do the impossible shot, send them in. You could win $5 for a gift card at ice cream at Bluff Park, plus some stickers. Don't forget, it's also dress up camp, so dress up like your favorite Lego minifigure. Have an awesome week. I just realized these... We had to cut the air conditioning back off because it got too cold in here. We froze it. Now it's getting a little warm, and I think the snowballs are starting to melt. So we better get these in the freezer quick. Have a great week. See you guys later. Oh, you gotta be kidding me! Oh, there goes Christmas.